Your film begins with the phrase, "I believe in America." What does that mean exactly?
Fortune, there is a crime. Honorary de Balzac wrote this in La Pierre Gorée. You see, America's birth was essentially a land grab. Hell, Jay Gatsby became who he was by selling illegal alcohol and even part of his soul. Joseph P. Kennedy's son became president. Vito came to Ellis Island as a broke refugee. He crafted a dynasty, an empire built on family. He wanted that success for Michael. And do you know what success is, my good friend?
And what's that, Mr. Coppola?
America. It's dream. People came to America to succeed and prosper, which is exactly what Vito and Michael gained. In a way, their story reflects the dark side of the American dream. They, just like many people, believed in America's success. However, that success was gained mostly through violence, loss, and hardship.
How exactly is murder related to the American dream?
It's not specifically killing people that relates to the dream, but rather the intentions behind it. The mob kills to achieve their own aspirations. They want money. They want power.
Go on.
President Richard Nixon rose to his aspirations and his dreams through sabotaging the potential end of the Vietnam War, as well as cheating an entire election by breaking into the Watergate building, stealing information on his opponent.
Very profound, Mr. Coppola. In what way would you say these traits connect with most American citizens?
Not only has our film romanticized America's dream, but it stays a film about family and bondage. While for people today, their family may not be physically existent, it can be something else. A group you love, a friend of yours, a dog, a cat. Family is a thing you protect. When Michael hears of his father's assault in part one, he scrambles to the telephone booth to call the family. Kay Adams, his girlfriend, is left outside in the cold. Michael would rather help his family instead of giving Kay attention.
But, Mr. Coppola, most American citizens can't connect with being in the mob or killing innocent lives.
Sure, but Americans can relate to that of defending and providing for their loved one, having a family, and even wanting to strive for a higher success. When you have lines such as, "You touch my sister again and I'll kill you," or, "I don't want anything to happen to him while my mother's alive," you start to see that it's not about the violence, but about its intent.
And how did you come up with all of this?
Because The Godfather is the story of my family. We were immigrants, just like the Corleones. We have aspirations, just like the Corleones. We are human, just like the Corleones.
This may be a reason why the film succeeded. People loved this movie because it was relatable. It says here that your film has a 97 critic and 98% audience score on Rotten Tomatoes.
Yes, sure does. I can't give myself all the credit, though. The cast and the crew really brought this picture to life. Hell, so did those sons of bitches at Paramount.
If you were to say there was one person who contributed the most to the production of this film, who would that person be?
Undoubtedly, the late Mario Puzo, author of The Godfather.
Mr. Coppola, you, like the Corleones, are also of Italian descent.
Well, there's people that hate the Corleone family in the films. There were people that hated my family in real life. I wanted to humanize Italian-American culture.
It must have worked then. There's more diversity in film than ever before.
I wanted my audience to relate to people who possess different traits than them.
I've read about this in Tom Santopietro's The Godfather Effect. He claimed that the film changed Hollywood because it finally changed the way Italians were depicted on film. It made Italians seem like more fully realized people and not stereotypes. It helped Italianize American culture.
I'm glad the audience realizes Puzo and I's vision. Godfather is a film with mobsters who aren't portrayed as bloodthirsty animals, but rather Americans, fathers, husbands, and sons.
So tell me, Mr. Coppola, how has The Godfather pushed to the American frontier of filmmaking?
With mobsters that strove for success and featuring unbreakable family ties, The Godfather is a film which was always intended to link both the ideals of Americans and Italian Americans. The film is intended to act as a relatable, moving picture. It presents that white American men are not all that American. Italian Americans represent the themes of being an American, as do African Americans and Asian Americans and other ethnic groups. The Godfather helped humanize other races, creating the gateway for more diversity and more equality, not just in filmmaking in America, but in the world.
Thank you for your time, Mr. Coppola. I've learned a lot today.
Sir, you forgot something?
Yes, Mr. Coppola?
Take the cannoli.
Thank you, Mr. Coppola.
Mr. Coppola, your 2:00 is here.
Send him in.